Breaking news tonight, the Secretary of Homeland Security, Kirstjen Nielsen, is accusing Democrats of being cowards as she doubles down on the Trump administration's attempts to deflect blame for the separation of immigrant families at the border. Let's bring in our analysts and our experts. And Susan Hennessy, help us understand the law as it stands right now, because she says they're simply trying to enforce the law, which earlier administrations didn't do.
Yeah, the law absolutely does not require this. This is a policy decision, and I think it tells us everything we need to know, that the entire administration is trying to blame someone else, is refusing to own this. You know, to some extent, their focus here on the question of legality, whether or not the president has, the parents have violated the law or not, is sort of besides the point. We know that this policy is designed to be a deterrent. We know because John Kelly sat in this very chair and told it to you personally. We know it's because it's been in hundreds of Trump administration documents that this is a policy designed to deter. A policy designed to harm children as a means to deter their parents from legal or illegal conduct is immoral. Beyond that, it doesn't even work. We have lots and lots of evidence in Europe and the United States that these policies aren't even going to accomplish the ends that they're intended to. So really, it's just cruelty that is not required by the law for cruelty's sake.
Can I just add to that, because I agree with everything you said, is that this notion of blaming Democrats, has anybody told the Republican Party that they actually control the Congress? I mean, they sound like, oh, we're blaming the Democrats. The Democrats are in charge. The Democrats are not in charge. The Republicans are in charge. And this president himself last Friday, if I recall, I'm sure all of you do, didn't even know what immigration bill he was supporting. So you have these mixed signals. You have these lies about whether or not the president could just call and end this, which, of course, he can. But they're using it as a negotiating tactic because they want to get everything. And she did not answer the question of, well, what if you got a lot of what you wanted, but you didn't get the wall? Would you then sign on to that and end this kind of deterrent? And there was no answer to that.
And you got a whole bunch of Republicans now, Ben Sasse, Ted Cruz, a lot of Republicans, former First Lady Laura Bush. They're all coming out and quickly saying to the White House, you're wrong. Stop this.
Right, because people see that there's a moral imperative behind this that should go beyond party lines. And to add to Gloria's point, the tell for the administration that they are essentially taking a legislative hostage with these children that they don't have to do was toward the end of that briefing today when Francesca Chambers from the Daily Mail asked the press secretary, if you really want to change this policy, why not just support a bill that just changes this policy? And she could not answer that because it's clear that they want to use this in negotiations.
Clearly, they want to tie this to the president getting $25 billion to build the wall with Mexico.
Well, sure, because it's clearly not tied to the law. When I moved in government and when I transitioned over in 2005 to the FBI, the director of the FBI says, we have priorities. We're going to spend a lot of money on counterterrorism and counterintelligence and less money on other stuff. It's like the president, when he walked in within 48 hours, says, we're prioritizing limiting immigration from these countries. Remember that? The Muslim ban. Mm-hmm. We're doing that by executive order. Now he's saying, I cannot establish priorities in an executive order to limit this separation of children from family. Let me tell you something. Well, if this isn't about lawyers, lawyers do, as I learned in government, what you tell them to do. When I was at CIA after 9/11, lawyers said it's okay to bring detainees to black sites, CIA secret facilities, and subject them to a harsh interrogation measure. You know what the Obama lawyers said? The president says that's not okay, so we decided that's not okay. This is not about lawyers. This is about the president saying this is okay, and I'm going to hide behind lawyers.
The thing that I think is important to note is the law does not compel this. There is enforcement discretion here, and so ultimately this might be consistent with the law, but whenever they say it is required by the law, that is false. That is a lie.
Well, this is about zero tolerance policy, if you'll recall, which was justified by the attorney general using the Bible, okay? So we either use the Bible or you're blaming Democrats or saying it's not a policy. It's confusing at the very least. And I think they want to keep it confusing because the truth of the matter is the president could stop this immediately if he wanted to do so.
With one quick phone call, take a look at the poll that we released here at CNN earlier in the day. Change in policy toward immigrant families at U.S. border, 28%. Approve of what the president is doing, 67% disapprove. But look at this. When you focus in on strictly Republicans, 58% approve of what the president is doing. 34% disapprove.
Right. 2/3 of all Americans disapprove, but almost 6 out of 10 Republicans approve. And I suspect, Wolf, that if you drill down to the president's strongest supporters, more of them approve of the policy. And the president and the White House know this. This is, though, a tension between two things that the president likes to be. He likes to be a strong man, but he also likes to be the benevolent, who's your daddy, you know, Trump loves the kids guy, and they can't reconcile this. In this case, you have to be one or the other.
You know, Phil, let me play some audio. I played it earlier, but it's worth playing again. This is courtesy of ProPublica. CNN has not independently verified. It's just audio of kids being separated from their moms and dads at the border. And listen to how they're reacting. They're crying.
Bueno, aquí tenemos una orquesta.
Mommy, Daddy, you know, you hear that. It's so heartbreaking.
It is. And the fact that we're hiding behind the law has told us things in the history of the American Republic. That told us things like an American woman can't vote. That was the law. It told us things like a Japanese can go to an internment camp. That's the law. It told us at the beginning of this Constitution in this country that a black man was less than a white man. It told us that a white man could own a black man, and we hid behind the law. And again, we're saying the president can issue an executive order saying that this is wrong, and instead we say the law holds us back. Well, it held us back before, and we paid. Kirsten Powers and the president will pay. This cannot
be. Kirsten Nielsen.
Yeah.
The Secretary of Homeland Security,
right.
Kirsten Nielsen. How much longer, Gloria, can the White House hold out and continue this policy?
This is a policy driven from the top, the very top. I mean, you've got the president clearly is out there on the record. He feels like he can blame other people, which is his MO. He always blames other people. I have no idea how long they can go on, but the once you get more pictures and once you get more audio, I mean, it's a crisis for them, to tell you the truth, and they're going to have to figure out a way out of it.
And those images of those little kids, so heartbreaking as they're being ripped apart from their moms and dads.